We've used simulation in a multitude of areas to prepare our medical staff and troops to be better prepared on deployment, to develop their clinical competencies in areas that they may not normally acquire during their day-to-day working life, and more recently to improve the teamwork and functioning of our UK medical defence teams, but also the interactions with foreign countries that are, we will be working alongside. Many more of our deployments now are international field hospitals where there are different practices, different cultures and themes, and the ability to use simulation to rehearse those scenarios before the deployment has been an invaluable tool to improve the teamwork and functioning. Simulation starts at the bottom level in our part task trainers and practical skill stations on courses such as the Battlefield Advanced Trauma Life Support, Battles course, where combat medical technicians and medics and nursing staff learn to apply combat applied tourniquets, the pelvic binders, intubation, airway control, cervical collars, IV access. So the practical skills that they'll be required to use on deployment. More importantly, they then learn how to, with the focus of a mannequin, work together as a team and coordinate those activities of resuscitation and stabilization, preparing while help is on the way to retrieve the casualty to stabilize and resuscitate to the best abilities. So it's bringing the clinical skills together, having a simulator as a focus for that activity. They work on the team activity to promote more effective care, often under fire in the environment that's different to their day-to-day jobs in the back home in a hospital. The mannequins we've used for specific team training with the medical emergency response team, the MERT, and we will put a mannequin in the back of an aircraft trainer, whether it be a fixed wing or a rotary aircraft trainer, to simulate the audible and noise, the distractions that can occur in their workplace on deployment, but to enable them to try and develop strategies to function as a team and coordinate their activities of resuscitating on the back of an aircraft, where voice and sound and the ability to talk to each other is hampered by the environmental noise from the aircraft, and you have to develop other subtle ways of communicating. So the interpersonal interactions has been an invaluable option. We've used simulators on our critical care retrieval teams, where the loading and the practical considerations of monitoring for our intensive care patient can be rehearsed in a risk-free environment. And I think most importantly, we've used mannequins in our multidisciplinary and interprofessional team training for pre-deployments for a five-day course based currently in London, where ED physicians, surgeons, and anaesthetists, nurses, and the surgical team have the ability to work together in the function that they're going to be doing. We can create a resuscitation, an amputation, a blast injury, penetrating trauma, start to acquaint the candidates with the trauma that they're going to see so they get some familiarity with the blood, the injury patterns, and the aggression that they may see, but also work together coping strategies, how they're going to work and function in a high-performing team environment in the resuscitation bay of the field hospital.